Doom engine is very simple by today's standards, but it's still difficult to keep track of everything happening under the hood. Every few milliseconds, hundreds of lines of code are executed, for every monster, every bullet, and even every little particle. But on top of all this complexity, there is a simple structure, the states table. In this video, we'll explore how it works, why it matters for Doom modding, and the origins of state hacking from the old MS-DOS times. What is a state? A state in Doom is a very simple concept. Take a look at this enemy launching the attack. They're displaying a certain frame of animation and performing a certain action. These things combined are called a state. There are of course many frames of animation, so the enemy has many states and is switching between them all the time. Let's analyze this pinky demon. It's currently idle and loops through only two states. Each of them has a defined duration and a pointer to the next one. As long as nothing important happens, these states will continue switching all by themselves. But when the monster is disturbed, the game instantly forces them to a completely different sequence of states. They will continue from there until the next important event. The demon deciding to attack is one such event. A sequence of three states is played and then switches back to the walking part. When the pinky is hurt, it has a chance to get stunned and forced into another two states. When the pinky dies, six states are played. The last one is special, its duration is declared as infinite. So finally, no more switching. Poor pinky stays like this forever. Unless... Archvile Resurrection plays yet another 6 states, and then the monster is up and running. In total, 27 states define how a pinky looks and behaves. Monsters are the most complex objects in Doom, thus they have more states than almost anything else. The biggest amount goes to Mancuso. He's a big boy after all. State structure has another important aspect. Actions. States can have actions attached to them, and these are what make them behave in a special way. Actions like perform an attack, or chase the enemy. Every action is a function in the source code. Internally, they can have quite complex logic, but it's all designed to run in a single game tick. Not every state has an action. A rocket has no actions while flying, but when it hits something, it plays a state with explosion action, then finishes the animation with two more states. Even simple decoration objects have states. This torch has four simple states, just for animation frames. And this tree only has one. Player weapons rely on states as well. Like before, they define animation frames and actions. Interestingly, muzzle flashes have their own separate sprites and separate states. Weapon fire action activates flash sequence, which runs in parallel. As you can see, lots of objects have states. Enemies and decorations, weapons and projectiles, even ammo pickups and power-ups. In total, Doom has 967 states. They're hard-coded as one big state table, and it was always possible to modify them without recompiling the source. By mixing and matching sprites and actions, you can have interesting custom enemies, borrowing abilities from other monsters and objects. One of the main ways of doing it is DeHacked. It's the most widely supported standard for Doom modding, taking its roots in the old MS-DOS times. Let's see how it worked back then. Originally, DeHacked wasn't a standard, but a small standalone utility program. Developed by Greg Lewis, it allowed to modify Doom EXE itself, to change all kinds of stuff, including the states table. Remember the states in the source code? Well, compiled into EXE, they look something like this. Not as readable, sure, but all the same values are here. Let's modify a few states and replace Zombie Man attack sprites with Nazi sprites. Then run the modified copy. And behold, our modification is working in the original DOS release. DeHacked utility streamlines this process, and of course it's more convenient for this task than a hex editor. Replacing state actions was also possible, but it required a more difficult procedure. One does not simply edit the states table to change actions. Here's the state where I input X, and this is where the action pointer is. You can actually put any value here and it will have no effect. The game doesn't even break, just nothing is changed. What's the deal? Well, an action pointer is a memory address. It's supposed to tell where a function is located in the program. When MS-DOS loads the .exe file, it's placed somewhere in memory. Next time on another computer, it might be another place. Both times it's the same .exe file, but using the same address would point at different places. That's why the executable contains a special relocation table. For each pointer we have a relocation record. When the program is loaded, the address fixup is performed. It takes the program's base address, combines it with relocation records, and puts correct pointers directly in memory. So if you wish to change pointers in the states table, you must go after the relocation table instead. With the help of reverse engineering efforts by Matt Fell, DeHacked creator Greg Lewis figured out where exactly to find all the relocation records and how they correspond to states. Based on DeHacked source code, I've compiled a little table to change state actions by hand. Let's replace the Baron attack with the Revenant missile. We find both actions in the relocation table, then copy Revenant's value over to the Baron spot. And there you go, we have hacked state actions. But it's a limited approach.
Of course it's limited, it's freaking Doom.
DeHack can only operate by copying existing relocation records from other states. Here is a problem. When DOM source was compiled, if a state had an action pointer, a relocation record would be generated. But no such records were created for states without pointers. As a result, DeHack didn't support adding actions to states which didn't have them originally. Without relocation records, those wouldn't work properly. Here's another problem. If a state does have an action, you can't remove it, only replace it. To remove it, we'd have to set the pointer to zero, but then the relocation record will unwantedly put the pointer back. So yeah, just because of how the original DOM was compiled, vanilla-compatible DeHack patches have the same limits to this very day. Are you tired of editing executables just to put together a simple mod? There has to be a better way! In 1997, DOM source code was published, and soon enough, source ports became a thing. Still, DeHack remained a standard, and even modern level packs use it to their advantage. Many source ports can load DeHack patches natively, and megawatts come with them conveniently packaged in. Also, more advanced modding tools became available. Boom extended DeHacked, Decorate, MBF21, just to name a few. Nowadays, it's easier than ever to make silly little mods in a matter of minutes. But this is a whole other topic, maybe another time. As always, I hope you learned something new, or at least had fun watching. Thank you all, and see you around!